The summer months are just as important as deer season is to us, and we have a blast. This gives us a chance to prep and improve before fall comes back around. We are constantly pouring big time out to our deer herds to keep them healthy and are running several covert cameras to build up our hit list. But just like anything else, you can't have all fun without a little bit of work here and there.
All right, guys, me and Chase just made it up here to our lease in Indiana. We've got tons of mineral stations out, so it's 10 days away from go time here, and we're gonna go pull up all the dirt, shovel it up, put it in the back of this truck, and then put fresh dirt down, pile brush on top of it. That way it ensures that our deer won't be hitting the sites anymore for season. Also, we've got some other work to do. We've got our hunter safety system, lifelines. We're gonna hang these in every stand. These got the double straps on there for the hunter and the cameraman, so that makes it nice. If you don't have one of these, you need to definitely get one for your family. Being safe, first and foremost, is the most important thing. Another thing we're gonna hang is these quick connect tree straps. This is the three pack from Hunter Safety System. But we're gonna put, you know, doubles up in the stand. That way when you go up there, you just unhook from this, clip it right on there. You don't have to mess with, you know, putting your strap around the tree in the dark, and it's a lot quieter. So come along, join us, and you can get in on some of the action. It's not all fun and games, but it's a lot of work, but we call this kind of work fun. So you're watching License to Kill Outdoors, and the work begins.
One thing that we as hunters often forget is tree stand safety, and there's nothing more important than returning home safe.
License to Kill Outdoors is brought to you by Tribe Archery. Adventure is waiting, Tribe Archery can get you there. Ripcord, America's favorite arrow rest. Steady form. Shoot with confidence. Kischel's. Sense for success. Flying Arrow Archery. Changing blood trails forever.
Get a steady form and shoot with confidence.
We decided to stay completely out of this particular farm until opening morning of gun season. We had tons of great bucks on our covert scouting cameras and knew with the low pressure that it was going to be a great farm. So I held off and decided opening morning that I would take my bow out and my gun and hope to catch one of these big bucks in bow range.
Good morning. It is the opener of Indiana firearm season, so the Orange Army is out full force. They wouldn't let us down. They've been shooting since we left the truck this morning. We've seen a couple, well, Brian's seen a couple running for their life. But we just got word that Carter just shot a buck, pretty decent buck. So fingers crossed, good job, buddy. Hopefully they can find him. So it's perfect morning, it's calm. I got Brian running the camera. Stick with us, it's gonna be a fun morning. Hopefully everyone stays safe and has fun. You're watching License to Kill Outdoors.
I looked over, and here come one of our shooters heading straight into us. Now this wasn't my number one choice on shots, but I knew this buck was tracking the Kischel scent that I had sprayed on my boots and was going to end up tracking us straight to the tree and looking up at us. So I put that toxic broadhead in the best place possible.
That's a stud.
That's a good one.
He put his head down. I put it right in between his shoulder. I don't think he's taking that far, and he is done.
Nice.
Oh yeah, baby. You, with a bow opening morning.
You and Carter.
Right after I shot this buck, we decided to go ahead and hang tight. My mom was hunting just over the hill, and we were starting to get flooded with bucks. This was by far in the top three on my most favorite hunts. We had bucks chasing does all over us, and it was a beautiful morning, and I think the number one key that we had here for success was staying completely off this farm and the low pressure and just, you know, scouting off of our covert cameras and going in at the right time.
Closed captioning is brought to you by Big Time Deer Supplement. Attract, develop, grow.
Floyd just shot one of our top hit listers, and my wife Candy and I are right over the hill, and we're hoping she can get a tag on her first buck.
Shot one, so I'm hoping to get one. I've yet to see any deer yet, but the word is they're headed my way.
finally, out pops the first deer of the morning. Now we're gonna wait for his big brother. This spike kept looking behind him, and I knew it was only a matter of time.
Behind him in your scope.
I don't want to hit it yet.
If you're on him.
Is I'm on him?
Yeah. You dropped him.
Did I really?
Yeah, you dropped him.
A buck. I don't know how big, but he was right there. It was pretty exciting. I hadn't seen anything at all, and then a little spike buck came in, and Floyd's been texting me telling me they're on their way, and so I just shot my first buck, my first deer ever. It's 8:33 a.m. That was pretty cool. I got a text chase.
I don't know who was more excited when the smoke cleared from that traditions and her buck was laying on the ground.
Okay, we know my deer's down, but we need to head back to the truck so that we can get a pen and paper for a transportation tag. Then we're going to meet up with Floyd and Brian, who aren't too far away, and track Floyd's deer, hoping to get it, and then we'll come back and get mine. And it's 30 degrees out here, so it is really cold, but Dean's right, these camo are working. And the hand warmers and the toe warmers. So stay tuned.
If you're a hunter out there, then that means that you have family at home that loves you, do your family a favor and buy a Hunter Safety System Lifeline. It's just not worth taking the chance. You're safe from the time your feet leave the ground to the time you hook on to your strap up in the tree. Simple, unsnap. And you get to go home and see your family after a successful hunt, so it's all worth it.
License to Kill Outdoors is brought to you by Plythol Lethal Layering System. Apparel like you've never experienced before. Hooker Deer Drag. Take a hooker to the woods with you. Hunter Safety System. Saving lives is what we do. Grizzly Coolers. For a lifetime. Catskill Mountain Calls. If I wouldn't put it in my turkey vest, I wouldn't put it in yours.
We shot this buck 7:30 this morning, and the shot looked good. It's not a what I would classify as a picture perfect scenario by no means, but I trust in my equipment. I've said it once, I'll say it again. If you trust in your equipment and you're confident then that you can make the shot, then do it. So I did it, and hopefully, fingers crossed, this buck didn't make it out of that CRP. That's the last sighting that we had of him. So we're gonna ease up here. The shot was high. He had his head down, as you've seen. So I don't know how much blood, how quick we're gonna have, but we did see where he entered the CRP, so we're gonna take a look. Lung blood, baby. There is why we shoot flying arrow archery broadheads.
He can't be lost.
Yeah.
there. Yep, right there. Game over.
In the creek.
In the creek.
He is a stud.
That will work.
This is a big old mature buck, for sure. This was probably the best morning I've ever had in the whitetail woods. Me and Brian sat there. I hit the horns together right at daylight. It's opening morning of our gun season here in Indiana. And this big boy came cruising right in. And I put it on him. He didn't take it far, that's for sure. I am blessed. A week ago today, I killed out in Ohio. And now my Indiana tag's punched. And you don't get any better than filling your tag on a big mature buck. My mom actually is with me and my dad to spend the morning and enjoy the memory. My mom killed her first buck this morning. This is a new lease we have, and actually our first time in here to hunt. We spent all summer scouting this in the fall and hanging covert trail cameras, and it paid off. The first time in, we got two bucks on the ground. Chase's boy Carter actually, they had a good hunt this morning. So fingers crossed, you're watching License to Kill Outdoors, and I have been blessed again with a giant.
We just found Floyd's deer and got it all loaded up, so now we're gonna go get mine and get it loaded up in the trailer. I can't wait to see it.
That's way bigger than my first one.
Well, that's more than yours. You just did. This is my first deer kill ever, my first hunt ever. Went out this morning with my husband, Dean, and it was pretty exciting. Now I know why he and our boys are so excited about hunting all the time. And it was really cold, but I managed to make it. I didn't freeze to death.
On this very farm, I took my first buck. It was an 8-pointer. It was about the same size as this deer. And we've been trying for a lot of years to get this farm back. And I guess it just kind of means a little extra something to me that she got her first one and Floyd killed a giant here this morning. So,
you know, don't get any better than to be able to kill two nice bucks like this the same morning on the same farm. And what's even more special for me is this was my wife's first deer, and she was able to take it on a farm that I killed my very first deer on back when I was 11 years old. So, you know, it's just one of those things for me that life has come full circle for me.
Man, that's cool. It never gets old, no matter how many times you kill a deer. I don't care if it's a freaking squirrel, I love it.
Thanks for watching this week's episode. We hope you enjoyed it. Make sure to check us out on the web at ltkoutdoors.com and give us a like on Facebook. Thanks. We'll see you again next week, same time, same place, right here on Tribe Archery's License to Kill Outdoors.